The idea of extraterrestrials and alien life has been debated for as long as man has looked up at the stars. The legends of ancient gods descending from the heavens in flaming wheels within wheels, to the theory that proposes many ancient monuments, depict aliens. The aliens that brought the knowledge we use to found our civilizations. Since those days of old, alien interactions have left sparse amount of evidence on this planet. Why is it that they have gone from the creation of huge megalithic structures to appearing in grainy photos? Could this be because they no longer exist? Scientists are saying aliens aren't calling because they're dead. Let's take a look. Welcome to IF, videos on history and mystery. Hit that subscribe button and ring that bell so you never miss a video again. Here on Earth, we have it pretty good. This planet sits in the perfect position. We are the exact correct distance from our star, the Sun. It's not too hot or not too cold. We inhabit the area of space that has famously been named the Goldilocks Zone. We are not the only planet or moon that inhabits this ideal distance from a star. And this is what many point to when discussing the chances of finding alien life on another world. It is often the first stop when searching the universe for life. If a planet is orbiting at this distance, the chances of locating liquid water are high, and this could easily then lead to the discovery of life, water being the one constant that is needed for life. Mars has always been a favorite planet for those searching the stars for alien life forms. The recent discovery of puffballs on the planet and the alleged Martian fossils and relics point to an alien world that at one time is thought to have hosted life and may still be home to some hardy surviving life forms today. We looked at Mars and its artifacts in the video linked above. So where are some of the other planets life could have arisen? First up is Titan, the largest moon of Saturn and the second largest natural satellite in the solar system, at nearly half the size of Earth. Saturn has numerous moons, and many of these have caught the eye of researchers and are popular when considering a possible host world for alien life. Enceladus is less well known, but with its vast oceans of water buried 30 to 40 kilometers beneath the moon's surface, the moon's surface is covered in an extremely thick layer of ice and snow, temperatures on the moon reaching minus 198 degrees centigrade. Even with it being this cold, it could still be a suitable environment for extraterrestrial life to flourish. NASA discovered the moon held the ingredients for life in these oceans: carbon, nitrogen, and hydrogen. The Cassini space probe revealing the existence of the elements which are seen as vital for life to form. Other places have been put forward as good candidates for organic life to exist. Jupiter is similar to Saturn in the way it has moons that could provide suitable habitats for life. Jupiter's moon, Europa, has been the target of exploration since the 1960s. Europa, like Enceladus, has a liquid ocean hidden beneath a layer of thick ice, some 15 to 20 kilometers deep. Next year, a number of probes are scheduled to arrive at the moon and start searching for the indicators of life on the icy moon. Scientists are not only looking at moons. Last year, a study reported the existence of a possible super-Earth-like planet about 41 light-years away from us. LHS-1140b, as it was so imaginatively named, is about 1.5 times the size of Earth. Like our planet, it sits in the sweet spot, the habitable zone of its star system. LHS-1140b was discovered by the M-Earth project, this project seeking out Earth-like planets. They have found three potential planets so far: GJ-1132b, GJ-1214b, and LHS-1140b. And it doesn't stop there. The Kepler Space Telescope has identified a planet now known as Kepler 452b. This planet is some 60% larger than Earth and is located in the Cygnus constellation. Rounding out this list are TRAPPIST-1, TRAPPIST-1b, and TRAPPIST-1c. These planets were found 39 light years from Earth. The solar system these worlds inhabit has a central star, which these planets orbit at just the right distance to have liquid water and thus possibly life. It would certainly seem that there is no shortage of worlds that are suitable for life, and in the infinite expanse of space, the number of planets that could host life could be a number which is incalculable to current scientific thinking. But will we ever find some sort of intelligent life? Some say no. A controversial paper from a team of Australian astronomers makes the suggestion that we won't find life on any other world. They reason that while alien life may have once existed, today it is all dead. Why are they publishing such a fatalistic theory? Well, it's all down to the problem we are facing here on our planet, specifically climate change. This report, which can be found in the current edition of the Journal of Astrobiology, is where the scientists at the Australian National University attempted to solve the conundrum of Fermi's paradox. The Fermi paradox, or Fermi's paradox, given to the world by physicist Enrico Fermi. In simple terms, it shows the apparent contradiction between the lack of evidence and high probability for the existence of extraterrestrial civilizations. The scientists proposed the reason that we haven't had contact is because other planetary environments are too hostile for life to exist. They say that some form of life may have begun at some point, but it was unable to stabilize or survive rapid changes in fragile planetary environments and was quickly snuffed out. They look at our nearby neighboring worlds like Mars and say that around 4 billion years ago, it too would have been habitable. Venus would also have provided a suitable location for life to flourish at this point in time. But things change, and change they did. Mars becoming far too cold and the surface of Venus growing in temperature, wiping life from the planet or making it impossible for it to begin. This same situation is or has been repeating throughout the universe for billions of years. One of the doctors working on this theory stated that early life is fragile and that they believe it rarely evolves quickly enough to survive these planetary environmental changes, this adding to the unlikelihood of life in the universe. The doctor points to how most early planetary environments are unstable. For life to take hold, it needs stability. Long periods for it to slowly evolve into and possibly then even change the environment it finds itself in. This interaction between organic life and inorganic matter on a planet as a means of survival is called the Gaia hypothesis. The Gaia hypothesis, also known as Gaia theory or Gaia principle, proposes that all organisms and their inorganic surroundings are closely integrated to form a single and self-regulating complex system. This interconnected system maintaining the conditions for life to exist on a planet. This is what we see here on Earth, a chain that links all life to the planet. When this chain is broken, disaster follows. The singular, interconnected and dependent world model is extremely fragile, and with only minor changes, it can collapse like a house of cards. This is what the scientists propose happens most of the time, and will happen here on our planet. In time, the Earth will become another lifeless rock in the empty expanses of space. The claims seem to be linked to the current changes going on with this planet's environment. Those that are supporters of global climate change can point to this theory as the ultimate conclusion to the changes they say are caused by industrial practices that harm the planet. We are hastening our own extinction and deletion from the universe. With the researchers saying that higher forms of extraterrestrial life have been completely killed off or that they may have never evolved on other planets, and that microbial life cannot grow and evolve. We are the last vestige of life in the universe, and we should do all that is needed to protect the ember of life and kindle it into a flame, spreading life back out into the darkest reaches of space. Earth seen as an oasis in a barren, lifeless universe, from which mankind could take the seeds to grow a new world in the stars. This depressing prediction does, however, fail to incorporate ideas like the Kardashev scale, the Kardashev scale being a method of measuring a civilization's level of technological advancement based on the amount of energy a civilization is able to use. This is a flaw in the Australian scientists' theory. They do not seem to account for time and the evolution and development of a species older than humanity. Other experts say that as a civilization grows larger and becomes more advanced, its energy demands will increase rapidly due to its population growth and the energy requirements of its various machines. The society then develops to meet these needs. This is when we can use the scale to counter their argument with a Type 5 civilization. Type 5 entities would be so advanced to humanity, they would appear to be godlike, having the knowledge to manipulate the universe as they saw fit. They would be free from the environmental restraints outlined by the Australian scientists. They would be capable of accessing and manipulating all the energy in the universe, this rendering them immune to environmental planetary change. So maybe the lesson we should learn here is that we need to step on the gas when it comes to scientific advancement, or that if we do meet aliens, we become avid students of their technology. So what do you think? Are we really alone? Are the scientists correct in their fatalistic view of the universe? Let me know in the comments below. If you like what I do here on the channel, hit that red button, like and share. You can catch the latest by searching We Are If. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.